Today's event is called Auckland's Future Now. It's all about facing the challenges that the economy in Auckland has as a result of COVID-19. Today is going to work in two ways. One, we're going to hear from 32 speakers, but the other really important part is getting participation from the 200 people in the room. We've got all the brains of Auckland gathered together, and hopefully we'll come up with some amazing ideas. We're going to collate all of that down at the end of the day and present it back to the audience and the rest of Auckland.
We face a crisis with the COVID-19 pandemic, such as none of us have experienced before in our lifetimes. And we need to look at how we manage the threat and how we seize the opportunities that it presents.
I've always believed that Auckland is the magnet for international and domestic migration and growth. And, you know, I think you will inevitably see Auckland, you know, a very large city, home to millions of people that want to enjoy what we have here. There may well be an opportunity that's come out of COVID-19 to say, look, can we really get some big infrastructure projects ready and funded in a way that might have been more challenging if we didn't have what is a potentially looming economic crisis for the country.
We have the ability right now to really think about what we want to be known for so that we can have sectors in the future that are better reflect some of the new industries of the world, but also can really position us strongly in terms of innovation, creativity, and around this idea of trust.
We want an economy that is just, inclusive, regenerative and circular, and where the prosperity is equitably shared. And whilst we are in the midst of a crisis, it also presents us with an opportunity for a radical transformation and a new economy that enhances the mana of ordinary people and our planet at the same time.
Auckland's got an amazing opportunity to be really brave and to also create a vision for the future around how do we manage a COVID world, how do we take advantage of the fact that New Zealand is now seen as a safe and a sane place to actually come and do business and live.
Our panel today on health and cohesion talked about equity and talked about community. I think the two most important things that did make us survive really well with the COVID.
We have the same problems of social inequality, of congestion, of environmental degradation. All of the issues really for this community are the same as they were before COVID. They've just been put into a bit more of a highlight.
It's a wonderful city centre, so we can create apartment blocks and places for people to live and enjoy as well as work. We can expect an influx of people wanting to live here, and CBD and neighbourhoods can complement each other to create a really cool place to live.
Look at the opportunity that we've got, being able to tap into incredible talent, whether it be engineers, gamers, developers, technical people. They're assisting us with projects here in Aotearoa to really digitalise this nation. Only 1 to 2% of Māori and Pacifica are in tech careers. We've got to change that.
And 5 years from now, I would love to see a more cohesive, more connected, more collaborative Tāmaki Makaurau. And what that means is recognising the roles of public, of private sector, of small business, of large corporates, all playing a part in contributing, working together for better, equitable outcomes for our communities.
We need to be preparing ourselves for a future that may look different from the past. How can we, with partially closed borders, still make the most of our opportunities and boost our economy and boost our prosperity?
I see this as a time when Auckland can prosper, and I'm actually really, really excited despite the challenges around us. It's there for us to grab hold of and to seize that opportunity, and we have to move fast. Whatever roadmap we come out of today with needs to be a living document that we continue to evolve.
If Auckland's not the cosmopolitan centre, we don't have one. You know, this is it. I mean, we are the only city of international scale in New Zealand, and we have to succeed.
Today is just another step in a very important process of building momentum in terms of where we take the economy, working as Auckland, New Zealand.